Lathe and mill work is most of the time fun to do without the special need for automated CNC and programming. But how to avoid programming and the use of the graduated color handwheel and indexing plates when using the rotary head without all hell breaking loose? This rotary controller does it all for me with just the basic input values needed. I really start working within seconds. Invented rotary head controller. It is an all-in-one world's smallest controller with ultra-bright LED displays. No keyboard and no program skills needed. I designed this controller to do all heavy math, timing and sensor monitoring so that I can concentrate to operate the lathe and mill safely. Let's start by demonstrating how easy it is with my lovely assistant.
Hey!
There are five modes.
Mode 1 is rotate.
We turn on the controller.
Midlife crisis. Rotary control. Rotate.
We use a navigation switch to rotate the rotary head with positive degrees and negative degrees.
Second mode is go to.
We have to select go to with a motor switch. We want to go to the first hole position at 60 degrees positive. We enter 60 degrees. Moving up the navigation switch will increase the number. Moving down will decrease the number. We enter 6 with pressing OK. And press accept the value with pressing next. The second hole is 30 degrees positive relative. So we enter 30 degrees. Accept the value by pressing next. Now we want to go to the third position at minus 30, minus 60, minus 60 degrees is minus 150 degrees. We enter minus 150 degrees by pressing next first. We accept the value by pressing next.
Third mode is full.
With the mode switch, we select full. We have four holes at a full 360 degrees. We have to enter four positions. The sensor tells us that the drill has to be in upward position. So we go to the next sensor and move the drill upward. We enter four positions. We accept the value by next. The beep tells us it is ready, so we start drilling the hole position 4. The sound and the visual tells us to go back. The sensor switch accepts the next position, so we enter to rotate the next button. It will count down the position number from 4 to 3. And now we start drilling again. Until the limit switch is reached, we move upwards. Now the next sensor and the next position. Countdowning to position number 2. We start drilling this whole position 2. And go to the last hole position to drill. It returns to the beginning position to end this mode. This mode has also an auto function and it has to be switched on at start. We hold the next button while powering it on and auto will appear. From now on, auto is set with all functions that use it. We want to give in the four hole positions and enter 4. We accept by next. We now start drilling. And when it hits the next sensor, it turns automatically to position number 3. We start drilling again, moving it up to the next sensor, and it goes to position number 2. We start drilling again and go up to position number 1. This also can be used by making gear, by making
chain wheels, Geneva wheels, multi keys, and
radio holes. And we return to the 0 position. This is the end of this mode. Yeah.
Fourth mode is angle.
With a motor switch, we select the angle mode. And we want to drill 5 holes at a total angle of 180 degrees. We give in the 5 positions. We have to move the drill up to the next sensor. Give in 5 positions, accept the value by pressing next, we have 180 degrees, give in 180 degrees, accept the value by pressing next. Now the controller is ready, we start drilling position number 5. It rotates automatically because auto was set. Now we drill position number 4. It's gone countdown to number 3. Drill number 3. We drill position number 2. And last position number 1. And it knows that the mode is finished.
Fifth mode is slot.
With the mode switch, we select slot.
we want to make a slot of 45 degrees and 1000 milliseconds between stepper pulses. So we enter 45 degrees. We accept the value by pressing next. Now we enter 1000 milliseconds for feed rate. We press next to accept the value. We start the mill and lower it into the workpiece to start milling. Now we press next to start milling the slot. Deeper, we have to go back to the zero position. We accept the previous value by OK. Now we press next to return. Now it will give the previous values. We lower the mill a little bit further and press next to start milling the slot a second time deeper. We can repeat this procedure as many times as we like. This is the finish of the mode slot. These 5 modes can be combined to do special and advanced work. Next video I will make some objects on the mill with all these modes. See you next time.